Can you talk about what for you the true spirit of Peter Rabbit is and how this beautiful piece of cinema that you've made perpetuates that wonderful legacy?
Well, I think the reason that the Beatrix Potter Estate gave permission to this film, you know, over others is there's so many vignettes in the film which come from lots and lots of the stories. But ultimately, I think what the film's actually about, you know, with all the big comic set pieces and the pratfalls and all those things, what it's actually about, it's about acceptance. It's about feeling that lots of times you would think that someone's differences to you mean that you can't get on, and you would go, you would build a wall and go, well, this is mine and that's yours and you don't come in here. And actually, if you accept your differences, you'll actually start to find a lot more similarities, whether that's a relationship between a rabbit and a person or a person and a person. There will always be things that are different about you and someone else, but if you look for it, you'll find far more similarities. And that's ultimately what I think the film's about. Number one, there was phenomenal snacks in the booth where I recorded things. Number two is I would get to see Domhnall doing what is one of the most brilliant physical comedy performances I've seen, but acting with nothing, and it's incredible. And number three, I get to be here now talking to you. What a privilege.
Can you talk to us a little bit about James as the voice of Peter? Because it's such a beautiful matchup of casting, I think.
James has this incredible ability, as you all know, because we all love him, to say kind of inappropriate, cheeky things, but it comes from such a good face, a good place, and it's so funny, and it comes from such a good heart that it really is like the perfect voice of like an adolescent who says things he shouldn't or she shouldn't, but deep down, it comes from a good place.
Talk about what the real spirit of this particular Peter Rabbit adventure is.
Well, the spirit of this particular rabbit is we tried really hard to make it the same spirit as Beatrix Potter. So this Peter Rabbit is the same Peter Rabbit that I grew up with and my kids grew up with. So we hope that we tried hard to keep the spirit the same. You know, Domhnall did a lot of sketch comedy in Dublin at the beginning of his career, so I knew he was very funny. And then, of course, he went on to do a lot of serious, although he was quite funny in Star Wars. So he's amazing ability to be really serious, very emotional, and really side-splittingly funny. And he's such a physical actor that he just throws himself into the part. And he literally gets thrown off buildings in this movie. So.
Yeah, and it's quite painful for him, the role.
You'll have to ask him, but it was not an easy shoot for him. Every time you see him do something, he actually did it.
So when he's fighting with Peter, what is he actually, like, what is he holding? What is he working with? Anything?
He's holding an array of things. He's holding little women and men in blue suits. He's holding little balls. He's holding little sticks. People are throwing things at him. The air is throwing at him. And oftentimes, he's just acting against nothing, which is very hard.
We've seen you playing a few bad guys lately, but tinged with a lot of comedy. Can you talk a little bit about the appeal for you as a performer of playing the bad guy and the joy when, like in Star Wars and here, there's different levels to it?
I wouldn't say that he's like all bad in this film. I think he's open to love, which is slightly different to the other one. But yeah, there's lots of fun to be had. If you turn up with an attitude and you know what he wants, then it's kind of, then it's more fun to play.
It's an amazing cast alongside you. I have to ask though, why do you keep trying to kill Daisy Ridley?
She just annoys me. I want her off this earth, so I'm doing my best to do it on film.
What was your most memorable day on set? Like, looking back, what was your favourite?
I got to be in like a speedboat going down the Thames, which felt very, very cool. Wearing sunglasses, that was kind of that was about as cool as it gets.
What favourite is you having a meltdown in Harrods?
Also fun. Also a good way to spend a day. Yeah. It was very challenging at times. Yeah, having a fight with something that's not there is difficult to do. But tricky at times. But they've made it look so beautiful in the film. Like the animation is amazing. So thank God it worked out. We had quite a few stunty type things in the film, so I had to work with the stunt coordinators on that and working on the routines to make them funny. And then it was just working on the script with Will, you know, really trying to understand what he wanted and how best to get that across. That was most of the prep, to be honest with you. What I'm hoping to take away is the experience of being in the cinema with a load of kids while they're laughing and having a good time at something that I'm involved in, because that's the reason I did the movie in the first place. Apparently it's gone fantastic. Lots and lots of people have gone to see it in America. People keep going to see it, so that means they're hearing about it from their friends and stuff. And so hopefully the same thing will happen over here.
The timeless magic. I think they just speak to everyone, whether you're a parent, or, you know, a grandparent or a child. They touch your heart as soon as you dive into them.
Can you talk a little bit about what fans can expect, I guess, particularly from James's performance as Peter Rabbit?
When I first got the movie, I said James was born to play Peter Rabbit. I mean, he does such an amazing job. Everyone in the movie does a fantastic job, and it's hilarious. It's got a lovely message, and all the fabulous talent, the voice talent, it just adds so much to it.
In terms of that message, can you talk a little bit about what the spirit of this particular Peter Rabbit adventure is?
It's a really lovely message. It's a message about love and family in a more general side of things, but also, you know, we do make mistakes, and you know, in this movie there's forgiveness and the togetherness of family and coming together in tough times. It's really, really lovely message. Yeah, it was a tricky one because obviously this is a more kind of cool, fresh take on the story, but we also wanted to keep the traditional element as well. So, you know, I actually started with the more band elements, with the drums, the bass, the, you know, more songy approach, because that's what Will's used to. And then on top of that, Will wanted it to be big and British, so I slammed a massive orchestra on top of it, and it seemed to work really well.
To ask about working with Will, obviously an amazing director, and it sounds like you had a great partnership on this.
Yeah, we did. You know, Will's not used to working with composers, so it took a while to warm him up to doing it that way. But the movie really needed score. It really needed that type of storytelling, and I've just had a blast with Will. He's such a smart, funny dude, and I hope we get to do a lot more together. I'm finishing The Man in the High Castle season 3. I've got DuckTales is going on. And other than that, just the dealing with a newborn at the moment. So that's my next project.
It was such an honor to be able to bring such a beloved character and all of his family and friends that Beatrix Potter created to the big screen for the first time. And it was also a challenge because it had never been done before. And how do you bring Peter to life in a big live action movie and make him true to the original designs of Peter, of Beatrix Potter, but also really believable and tangible? James is the perfect Peter Rabbit. He's funny, he's mischievous, he's warm, he's lovable. He's all the things you expect Peter to be and more. We were blessed with a great cast, both as human actors in Domhnall Gleeson and Rose Byrne, but also the voices of the triplets. I couldn't imagine a more awesome lineup than Margot Robbie, Elizabeth Debicki, and of course Daisy Ridley. I think little girls are going to be picking their favourites for weeks to come. Animalogic, the animation studio behind the movie, has been behind a lot of inventive movies like Happy Feet, the Lego movie, Lego Batman, and the design team at Animalogic worked really hard with our director Will Gluck to find that perfect balance of staying true to Beatrix's designs, but also bringing them to life in a really amazing 3D way.
You talk about working with Will, obviously a fantastic director and a great partner to have on this project.
Will's a great writer. He's got a fantastic wit and a sense of humor. He elevates the humor in a way that families can enjoy it, both the parents and the kids can enjoy it. And he was really successful in walking that fine line, keeping the integrity of the property intact, but also making it very inventive for new audiences.
We love the film. We're hoping there's going to be more Peter adventures. Is that something you guys have already discussed? Is that an ambition for you?
You make one movie at a time and you hope it's great, but of course you hope that audiences will love it and there'll be many more. Animalogic Studios is working on the Lego movie sequel right now.
See, that's a high standard to match. Do you think it's possible to exceed the amazing work that was done on the first film?
We're working very hard to make sure it's as good and better than the very first movie. We've had a lot of time to do that. We've worked very hard knowing that we've got a high bar to get to, but I hope we will.
I went and sat in a hutch of bunnies, and I was like, guys, how do I do this? No, my last session, I rolled off a plane, and I was like to Will, I'll do the best I can, but there's not much time. It sort of takes like half an hour to get into it as you're doing it. So you sort of, well, me anyway, I do like 2 pages of cues, and then I'd be like, oh yeah, I found it again, and then we go back and do them all again. Well, there's a lot of like running that you have to do. A lot of eating fruit, which we had to do. Yeah, I'd say, yeah.
An amazing cast you're working alongside here. How good a big brother is James, and why is Domhnall always trying to kill you?
I mean, all the time. That's actually so true. I didn't think about it in those terms. He's always trying to kill sort of me. I don't know. I think maybe he's such a kind man that there has to be some way to... No, I don't know. He's just wonderful. And James is great. Very funny. Makes interviews wonderful because I usually laugh the whole way through them and the time just races.
I think one of the things that struck me most about your character in this is how fearless, relentlessly fearless she is. And I'm curious how important a quality you think that is for the heroes we hold out for our young people, particularly our young girls.
I mean, on a sort of basic level, rabbits are pretty fearless, but obviously with the anthropomorphizing. But I think there's bravery in different ways. So I wouldn't say that like running headfirst into things and sort of screaming loudly, that's not the only way we can sort of summarize bravery. It's one way we understand bravery. Because I think Flopsy and Mopsy are just as brave in a different way. It's great to be part of it. It didn't entirely feel like living it per se, but to be part of it is wonderful. It's hard to sort of do something when you can't quite see how it's going to all come together. And when you're filming alone, but you're interacting in a group, it's quite taping alone. It's difficult to sort of envisage how that scene's going to be. But I feel like it turned out all right. I'm pretty happy.
What was your favourite thing about the outcome then?
That I think I love Beatrix Potter and I love this film. So I think that's great as a sort of someone who grew up with it. I think they've done a fantastic job.